Unique biomarkers for COVID reinfection identified in new study. In COVID-19, natural immunity doesn't seem to work efficiently as some can be reinfected. So a group of researchers devised a way to better track it down. They recently presented blood biomarkers corresponding to reinfection cases. Most COVID-19 cases are mild and don't lead to hospitalization, more common in those vaccinated. Yet chronic conditions, compromised immune systems, and advanced age make the disease worse in select individuals. Nevertheless, those who recovered from the disease are expected to have some degree of immunity. According to the US CDC, the emergence of variants and their mutations can increase the risk of reinfection. This is one reason why getting vaccinated is important in the fight against COVID-19. Vaccines can reduce the odds of catching the virus again, and if it happens, lowers the risk of ugly outcomes. Published in the journal MBio of the American Society for Microbiology, researchers have found that immunological blood biomarkers for reinfection and re-exposure to the COVID-19 virus. They mentioned that earlier studies showed rhesus monkeys have a similar clinical response to the coronavirus humans. So they used these animals to better understand COVID reinfection. In this study, a group of rhesus monkeys was infected with the coronavirus. Researchers wanted to replicate what happens in the real world: exposure, infection, recovery, and immunity. Then, they exposed the same monkeys to a SARS-CoV-2 variant at different doses. Blood samples were collected before and after the original infection and reinfection. Here's what they found. First, the blood from the monkeys showed unique biomarkers of infection. Researchers said that the biomarkers are so unique they could be differentiated from the original infection. That provided essential clues useful in speed tracking reinfection with the right type of tests. Second, the same blood samples revealed higher levels of antibodies that bind to the spike protein, nucleocapsid protein, or other parts of the coronavirus. Monkeys exposed to higher doses of the coronavirus had greater antibody responses. Since those were just animal models, the team had to match them with human results. So a collaboration with SpaceX was made, which allowed the team to get blood samples from a small group of people participating in a community-based surveillance cohort. These individuals had been reinfected by the coronavirus. Analysis of the blood samples pointed to the same thing as from the monkeys. If the techniques in the study could be used almost everywhere, experts would have a way to identify reinfection cases quickly. It might help solve the reason behind new outbreaks or surging cases. Do you agree that we should track down reinfection cases? Do you think blood tests are enough to chase them down? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching. Oh,